Welcome to our first live concert since December of 2019. It's great to see everybody here. It's great to see the kids on stage once again. We're really excited. This first performance is our fifth grade beginner band. They picked up their instruments for the first time in September, and they're going to play for you When the Saints Go Marching In.
evening, everyone. My name is Mr. Wallowich. I teach the choir for both the middle and high school here at the Camden Promise Charter School Network. We are excited to perform for you today. Most of these performers have not performed with the middle school before, and those that have haven't performed with us since the winter of 2019, so we are very excited to be here in front of you today, and we hope you enjoy our songs. Ready? So we have some band members that are coming up now. That's right. We have some multi-talented students that are in both band and choir, so we're making sure we have everyone here. Features two soloists. Our first is eighth grader Viangeli Vera, and our second is Ariana. You okay? Ariana, she's very excited to perform for you. All the songs that we picked out for tonight were chosen by our students. We decide which songs they would like to do. We've been working together for the fourth marking period to prepare this concert for you, and they really enjoy these songs and these pieces. And this last one we have, I think, is their personal favorite. So we hope you enjoy A Million Dreams. Thank you.
I close my eyes and I can see a world that's waiting up for me, that I call my own. Through the door, through where no one's been before, but it feels like home.
They can say
Thank you. We have our 7th and 8th grade concert band now. These are the students that have been playing their instruments since the 5th grade and through a global pandemic. So, thank you.
Thank you.
All right, thank you, thank you. This next song, we started playing this and practicing this for our spring concert 2020, which of course was canceled. And all of those students moved on to the high school, and you get to see those later. But I was determined, when we came back in September, I was just going to pick right off where we left and move forward. And so I was determined I'm going to perform this number. And so here it is, and ironically, it's named Tempest. And the name Tempest, by definition, means a violent windstorm, like the one we were supposed to get on Monday that never happened. So hopefully this little windstorm is a little bit better than that one.
Thank you.
Hello again, everybody. This is our Camden Academy High School Choir. All the songs, again, just like for the middle school, were selected by our student performers. After not having any real performance opportunities for the past few years, we really wanted to make sure that they got to put what they wanted to for the community and for their audience. So we really hope you enjoy all the selections they have for you today. Our next song features two more soloists. We have Leonelis and Deborah. They are fantastic singers, and this song I feel like is one of the songs that they really enjoyed learning, and I feel like with all of our time at home, we spent a lot of time watching some popular movies that came out, and I hope that you recognize this one and it moves you emotionally as well.
Desorientadas en dos capullos, bien abrigadas con sueños nuevos. Ya solo falta hacer lo necesario en el mundo que sigue cambiando, tumbando sus paredes. Ahí viene nuestro milagro.
Before we move on to our last song, we would like to recognize one of our senior members. We are going to give this student the National School Choral Award. This student has been a very involved member of the choir, not just in high school, but also throughout middle school, and really held together their section and helped run a lot of stuff for their section this year especially. So I am honored to present this award to Destiny Andrews. Again, that's the National School Choral Award. Our program would not be half as successful as it would be without wonderful students like this that put a lot of effort and time and energy into the program, even coming back from such a strange few years where we couldn't really perform our music. So thank you all, and I hope you enjoy our last number.
Two selections for you right now. Thank you. So now we're going to change styles. That was a piece from the Renaissance. It was actually two different Renaissance songs put together. It was called Renaissance Festival. And so now we're going to change drastically the styles for this next number. Okay, just give us one quick moment and we're going to get the rest of the high school band up here real fast. Hold on 1 second. Thank you.
Good evening and welcome to the final portion of our 2022 spring concert. My name is Mr. Downs. I am the director of the high school advanced band, or the wind ensemble, and some of our jazz combos. And the first song that you heard was the American Spirit March. Our second song that we're going to play for you tonight totally changes the pace of things. And it's a song we did last year during the pandemic. We had some fun with it, making some videos with it. And funk, you guys know that song. You have to pardon our housekeeping a little bit because we have to switch percussion from side to side. They do everything. They're the movers, they're the cleanup crew. They get stuck with all the dirty work. So here we go with a little bit of Uptown Funk.
Have fun with this, but don't play out the intro.
Thank you. We're going to change it up. The pandemic, not just in our school, but the past 2.5 years as far as music departments across the country, has taken its toll on just the attrition from people going to block scheduling, people to doing different activities, to not being able to learn music over the internet. And we certainly have suffered greatly, especially last year at the high school, where we had to drop a period so that we'd have an even number of periods and go on a block schedule. So
we were decimated number-wise, but we still, as you can hear, have a lot of talent. So a lot of the stuff we've done here tonight is very creative. Some of it's even smoke and mirrors. I'll tell that secret. But we have a really great group of people who are interested in doing little combos on their own, as you're going to see. Our next song will feature several of our musicians and a couple of our guests, of course. And it's a jazz combo, and it's Oye Como Va, and it features Darny Soldano on alto sax, Brian Marmoleos on bass, our guest Eddie Van Halen for the night, Mr. Jeff Monjack, who's one of our math teachers, and of course our drummer John Taylor. So this is Oye Como Va. is Darany Saldana, Brian Marmaleos, and John Taylor on drums. With a little bit of help from Mr. Good in the back. So, our last combo song that we're going to do, we put together in the past couple weeks, and every time this guy came to me with, I got another idea, I just felt the anxiety become more and more and more. And I looked at the notes and I'm like, we can't play this. We'll never learn it. We can't play this. We'll never learn it. Stop writing. Today, he came to me with more. And we actually can do it. This is a piece called Hang Loose. It was arranged by Mr. Monjack, who is a professional musician in addition to being one of our math teachers at the high school. It's called Hang Loose. It features a lot of individuals within the section. It features our rhythm section. And where's... Come on. Okay, that's her brother. It was somebody's daughter before. He's so new, we didn't even have a seat on stage for him. So it's called Hang Loose. It's a jazz fusion, something totally different than we've ever played before. And it really turned out to be awesome. So this is Mr. Monjack's version of Hang Loose. Sometimes we nickname it Hang On. Thank you. Thank you. We're going to take 30 seconds, and we are going to get those members of our concert band, the ninth grade band, to come back on stage and join us for one last number, which will be Night Fury, and it will feature the whole band.
We have one more announcement before we finish. We want to appreciate the three people that really put this together and were able to put all their effort into it. Mr. Wallowitz, Dr. Santone, and Mr. Downs. Can you come up? We show our appreciation by all of you guys being here tonight and supporting the band and the choir, the middle school, the high school, and giving us your attention and your time. And we give them flowers. Thank you so much.
They both said thank you. They're shy. Take mine.
You want to close the curtain or set up or just bring them out?
Okay. So before we start each year, this is my favorite part of the program, because we get to award a couple special awards to some people who have demonstrated excellence throughout the year and gone over and above what's being asked of them. And for that recognition, we reward them with two awards that are actually, well, it'll be three tonight, because they are national awards. The John Philip Sousa Award, we have a couple people who are walking around here who have been winners of our previous awards or have won. I was never a John Philip Sousa Award. I feel like I'm as old as John Philip Sousa. But it's certainly a privilege to be able to stand here and recognize the hard work and talents they put in, and my colleagues. Both Dr. Santone and Mr. Wallowitz working here, I had the privilege of working with them and teaching Mr. Wallowitz, and the hard work that Ms. Kaur has done as the chair of the performing arts department here at the middle school. It is truly a team, and the people that you see before me, and I'm talking about the 17 people that I have in my advanced band class, if I could give every one of them an award, they deserve it, because they are the ones that stuck it out. They're the ones that tried to learn last year online. We all know what happened with that, and you think it's bad trying to do math and social studies and science online, try teaching someone how to play a clarinet online or a trumpet. And for those of you parents who had that happening at your house, I apologize. Okay, I needed a paycheck. Dr. Santone needed a paycheck, so we had to give you something. And we actually have a guest with us tonight who was last year's John Philip Sousa Award winner and the Performing Arts Award winner from last year. And since we didn't have a concert last year, I'd like her to stand up and be recognized. And that's Melody Miranda. She volunteered to come back and help. She is a full-time student at Temple and works and just completed a great first year. So we're very proud of her. Another person that I want to note is Mr. Damian Ruiz Rodriguez, who was our Camden County Performing Arts Representative. He is a senior going on to college and he's going to do great things. And we have one more senior. Where is he? Mr. Jai Boggs, come on out. So, those seniors, we wish them well. So now, on to the awards. The John Philip Sousa Award, you can only present one. The winner gets, I hope they spelled his name right. The winner gets a paperweight and a pin, as well as a certificate. Pull that. Oh, there, I knew we were gonna drop some. And this is the paperweight. Ooh. Yep, there you go, you got it. You can get the pin. And I'll just read it because this kind of explains this person to a T. The John Philip Sousa Band Award, in recognition of outstanding achievement and interest in instrumental music, for singular merit and loyalty and cooperation, and for displaying those high qualities of conduct that school instrumental music requires. The John Philip Sousa Band Award is hereby presented to John Taylor. And he gets an A in gym class as well. Don't go anywhere. We got more. We got great prizes. Come on. Your paperweight, hold it. Is Miss Gilmore here still? Miss Gilmore was gonna take, there she comes. She's gonna take a picture. Here's your pin. So why don't you state, hold your, here, there you go. You don't want to hold the wrapper in front of it.
Okay. Look, you gotta have the mic when you said that.
I'm sorry.
Now you're holding the wrapper.
Okay, John Taylor. I'll give it to him in a second.
I can't.
Okay. The next is the Louis Armstrong Jazz Award. And this award is given to two people this year. It says, in recognition of outstanding achievements in the field of jazz, as demonstrated through superior musicianship, character, and individual creativity, the Louis Armstrong Jazz Award is hereby presented to, and there's two names, so don't clap after the first one, Darrenny Soldano, and Brian Marmaleos. Okay, Brian's not going to do a backflip. He's just going to get a picture taken. And where's our? Wait. So I owe you.
You hold the trophy because it's got Darren's name on it. Come on in.
Come on in.
Hold your award so you can see it. Hold your word. So turn it around.
Let's both hold this.
Okay.
Okay. Congratulations. No. No. Okay, so as soon as they get settled back in, we are going to conclude with Night Fury. We thank you all for coming out. For the middle school parents, hopefully you had a taste of what our program is like at the high school and what you have to look forward to, and we look forward to seeing you in a couple years.
Well, it's happening.